So let us come to the sales activities. So when we say free goods in SAP, okay, so not in SAP, let us leave out SAP for a while, okay. So when we say free goods, so what are all the kind of free goods you normally receive when you go for shopping? It's the new link. Second link, check the second link. So one is what we saw is one is buy one, buy two, get one free, which means you buy a same article two pieces and get one piece of the same article free. Okay, that is one scenario. And we have something called as buy two pieces of article A and get one piece of article B free. Okay, that is the another scenario. Okay. Sometimes you buy one crate of Pepsi, that is 12 pieces of 12 cans, but you pay for only 10 pieces. That is one scenario. And sometimes like you buy 12 cans of Pepsi, that is one crate. Over that you get 2 or 4 cans of Pepsi. Okay, that is the scenario. So when we say you buy 12, but you pay for only 10, okay, you buy a pack of 3 pieces, okay, but you pay for only one or two articles of that combination, okay, then this is called as inclusive free goods. Okay, so inclusive free goods is normally like you buy a certain quantity, okay, which in most of the cases it is a wholesome quantity. For example, one carton or one dozen or something, okay, you buy it in a whole quantity and your free goods is included in the same. For example, you buy 12 but you pay for 10 only, okay. So when the when the free good is included in the wholesome quantity, then it is called as inclusive free goods. Okay, and there is another scenario where you buy a certain goods or certain whole unit, over that you are being added the free goods. For example, let me say you buy 10 CDs, okay, along with that you get a CD rack free, okay. So over that whole quantity of 10, you get one piece of free goods, okay. And sometimes like it happens, you buy 12 pieces of Pepsi can, okay, over that you get 4 cans free, okay. So you are adding the free goods over the or above the wholesome quantity, and the free goods can be the same item as the main item or can be different from the main item, okay. In this case, we call this scenario as exclusive free goods. So right now what we had seen one inclusive free good and another one is exclusive free good. So most of the time many people will say like if the main item and free item are the same, then it is called as inclusive. If the main item and free item are different, then it is called as exclusive. No. Partially the statement is wrong. The exclusive goods can be, the main and free goods can be the same even in exclusive also. Okay. But only thing that differentiates the inclusive and exclusive is the quantity, wholesome quantity. For example, I buy 1 dozen. The article is being sold in 1 dozen normally. Okay. 1 dozen packet or something. I buy 1 dozen, but I pay for only 10, which means my free goods is included in the same thing. Okay. So that is the inclusive goods. So in most of the case, people tend to confuse inclusive and exclusive when it comes the main item and free item being the same one. Okay. So don't get confused. This is the definition for inclusive and exclusive. Okay. Can Sirisha say what are the and under what conditions the free goods can be given? Can you let us know under what conditions you give the free goods? Is it based on product or it is based on customers? Okay. So okay, when you say okay, I'm going to give free goods for next 1 week. Okay. So for what combinations you give the free goods? For example, if so and so is a customer, then I can give the free goods. Okay. That is the most specific one. And yeah. So when you say like, I don't mind anybody who buys it, but anybody who buys this material, I'll be giving the free goods. That is the most broadest one. Okay. So in between the, like, because I'm going to touch the condition technique. Free goods uses the condition technique. So in the condition technique only, we normally look for the most specific record first and then move to broader level. Okay. So here I had said, okay, if this is a customer, then I can set the then I can set my free goods. Okay. Else I could say I can slightly come out of or broader than the customer. So what I could say, if this is the price group of the customer, okay, whomever customer falls in that particular price group, I can give them free goods. Else I can say whomever customer falls in some price list, I can give the free goods. Okay. So I am coming broader and broader. Okay. First I looked for only customer, then I looked for this thing, what you call as price group or price list. Then I could say for a particular distribution channel, I can define that. So let me say, like, in my business I am having direct sales, I have agency sales and I have internet sales. Okay. So tomorrow I want to push my goods via internet. So I am saying whomever buys through internet sales, okay, that is internet sales distribution channel, they will be getting the free goods. So you are making your free goods dependent on distribution channel. And finally, the most broadest one, you say, I don't mind who buys it, I don't mind through which distribution channel they buy, say, okay. So whomever buys this article, I am going to give the free goods. So that is the most broad one, that is the free goods. Okay. So when I say, like, I want to meet certain conditions before giving the free goods, then I am referring to my condition techniques. Okay. So now, how many scenarios, I mean combination we have seen? One, only customer. Next one is the price group and material, price list and material, distribution channel and material, finally only material. So we have 5 combinations. So when we are going to create a condition records, we may want to create records for all the 5 channels or any of these 5 channels. Okay. So this is controlled by the condition technique. And each combination is controlled by creating a, which one? For each combination, what you create normally? condition record is the final one. You create for condition. No. Condition table, which is right here. Because, so let me say, if I want to create a condition records for figures. So, sales and distribution, master data, condition, I go to three good. So I create now. Okay. So as usual, when you create for NA00, okay, the system gives me a combination of what happened. As of now, there is only one combination, that is for customer and material. Okay. So let us add or expand over this. Okay. So we have given the most specific one. So what happens if I have only one combination of this for creating a free good? Okay. Then I'll be having, let me say, 50,000 customers. Then I have to create 50,000 entries for all the customers, which I don't want to. And another one, this is time consuming as well as waste of energy also. So I want to now add another combination. So we'll add two more combinations. The most specific is given, that is customer material combination is given. Then I will change to price group and then the only material. Okay. So if you people had worked on the condition technique, then you will be feeling comfortable with what I am going to do now. First one, what we normally do, we normally create the condition table. Okay. So I am coming to sales and distribution, basic function. Can anybody say why certain things are grouped under basic conditions and why certain things are not? Yeah, that's correct. So when you want to, even before running your first transaction, you must have certain things in place. For example, you must have your pricing procedures assigned. Then only the system will pick the thing, what you call it, your pricing. Then you must have your incompletion log. Only then the system will say the sales order is complete or not. So whatever you want to do, you must, even before creating your first sales order, you must have those things in place. Of course, free goods and material determinations are based on your business requirements. So that is why they are given in the basic functions. Okay. Okay, let us come to our pricing, free goods determination. There is only one combination. We are going to add more combinations on this. So let me create a condition table for my further this thing. So only 10 and 17 is there. Okay. So let me say create number 501. Okay. So I'm saying for this sales organization, for this distribution channel, okay, for this price list, okay, and for this material, I want to create a combination. So I go to technical view. In the technical view, I say, okay, so if I take this, okay, so I can find the material in the footer level, okay. So the sales organization, distribution channel, and customer are in the header level. Okay. I can even manipulate so that I can put the material in the top level and put the customer in the footer level. How I am achieving that? That is by marking the which one as footer field and which one is the text field for which I can enter the values. Okay. In my case, the footer field is the material, okay, and it is a text field where I am going to enter the values, and I am creating with a validity period, which means whenever I create any condition record, the system must ask for a validity. So I select that, okay, and I am going to, okay, let me, if I want, by default the system adds or appends all the table names in the description, okay. If I want, I can change or rename here everything, anything. So let me say I want only price list and material, okay. So I have changed that, okay. I am generating it now. I am creating as a local object. So whenever you are creating, what happens is sometimes some of my students, what they do, they will look for the fields in the field catalog, come in the alphabetical order. So first they will enter the distribution channel, then they will enter the material, then they will enter the sales price list, and finally they will come to the sales organization. Of course, their intention is correct. They want to create a table with the four fields. But what happens is when they do that way, the sales organization becomes the footer field or the text field. Okay. So I always used to tell them, so visualize your table before adding the field. So in which field you want to add the value for condition record. So you add it accordingly. Okay. So we created one for the distribution channel, sales organization distribution channel, price list and material. Now I am going to create another one that is purely for material alone. So by default, always you take the sales organization and distribution channel. So because we create sales orders based mostly on that. So I take the sales organization, distribution channel and material. Okay, so this is going to be my broadest level. So let me say material entered. Here I can change the description also. Okay, I go to technical view and see, yeah, material is in the footer level and it is the text field where I can enter the values, and I am going to create it with a validity period. Okay. Generate local object. Okay. So once I have created the condition tables, what I have to do next? Hello? No. I cannot assign this thing to condition type directly. Okay, I assign the condition tables to the actual sequence. Why? Because when I am creating a, so here when I created the combination, okay, there is only one, so I don't have any choice. Okay, but if there are more than one, I want to tell, okay, first look for the customer material, then look for the price list, then look for the material. So I am going to telling the system to search for the condition records in a particular sequence. So that is why I am entering all the newly created tables in the access sequence, where I am telling the system access these tables in a particular sequence. So that is why it is called as access sequence. So I select that access sequence, I go inside the accesses. See, as of now there is only one. So I am entering the second one. So that is my 501, and my third step is the 502. Okay. Fine. So after selecting that, I have to initialize the field. Okay. So, I mean, out of you three, who is from the rural background or small town? Nobody. Okay. Because in the in small towns and rural, you know, like we used to have these hand pumps in India. Okay. So what we used to do normally when you, if you leave a gap, so which means like if you are using a hand pump after a long time, it's not long time, sometimes even after one day, you won't get the water immediately. So what you normally do, you pour some water inside that and then you pump for a while. Because what happens is, there will be a vacuum already inside. So you clear that by pouring some water and then you start pumping. So within a couple of minutes, you will get the water. So even the mechanical engineering, this term is called as priming. So we used to do that, okay. So it means like in some way we are initializing the functionality. So here also I am going to do the same thing. I had entered everything, okay, these are all the fields. Now I am going to do the priming activity, or I am going to initialize that, okay. These are all the fields that are available for, these are all the condition tables and fields that are available right now. So I am selecting them, go to the field. The system will say field assignment not yet made. Yeah, fine. I am going to make that assignment now. So press enter. So it will take you to this screen. You need not do anything. You come to this screen and go back. So can you see the table number 501 that is grayed out, which means that has been initialized. Whereas the table number 502 that is not grayed out, which means you can edit it there. This is not initialized, so I have to initialize that, I have to select that, I go to field, enter, okay, here I can see what are all the things, okay, so that's it, I have initialized the table. So now, when you create any free goods, the system will first look for customer and material, then it will look for price list and material, and finally it will look for only the material entered. For which level the system finds the condition records, it will take that and it will ignore the remaining conditions. For example, when the system finds the condition record for customer material combination, it will take that and it will ignore the line number 20 and 30. Similarly, like if it didn't find any value in 10, line number 10, it will come to the line number 20 and look for the corresponding condition record. Okay. If it didn't find any, if it found anything, it will take that and it will ignore the material entered. Okay. So now I have entered the access sequence. Okay. Then only I have to assign this access sequence to the condition type. Okay. In the pricing we had a separate configuration for condition types because we had many type of condition types. For example, prices, discounts, taxes, surcharges, rebates, everything. But in free goods, you don't have anything like this. So, in a single line, you can say this is my condition type. Against that, you can say this is my access sequence. Okay. So, for NA00, we had assigned the access sequence NA00. Okay. So, that it is already assigned. So, then we have to maintain the pricing procedure. Very similar to our pricing procedure determination. Here also, okay, now you have to maintain a pricing procedure, okay. In the pricing procedure, as usual, you had entered only the condition type, student. Okay. Then we have to tell the system how to determine the pricing procedure, okay. You might have created 100 free goods procedures, but the system has to choose the right one. For pricing procedure, we used to the combination of sales area plus document pricing procedure plus customer pricing procedure. Similarly, if you go to free goods determination, here also we are going to have a certain combination. That is the same one. Ours is 1000, okay. Distribution channel is 10, division is 00. My document pricing procedure is A and customer pricing procedure is 1. Okay. For this combination, It is, I mean, the pricing procedure determination is exactly the same as pricing procedure. Okay. We enter all the sales area, document pricing procedure and customer pricing procedure. For this combination, system determined the free goods determination procedure of NA001. Okay. A, it is in the sales order. It is in the document type. Okay. Then, in the item category, which was our free goods item category? TAN is our standard. TANN is our free goods pricing. Okay. So, when we say free goods pricing, okay, what is the pricing type we maintained in TANN? Do you remember? Whether we gave it a zero price or we gave some price and give? Sure. One second. No, Abhin. We maintained it as full price with 100% discount. Okay. Sometimes, okay, because even though we say it is a free goods, obviously it is going to have a price. Okay. So now we can either give it as a full goods and maintain a 100% discount, else you can maintain it as no pricing. This, yeah, in the item category, yeah, in the TANN, go to pricing. Here you can manage. If you don't want any pricing for the free goods, then maintain it as no pricing. Okay. Else if you want to maintain it as the full pricing with 100% discount, then choose the B. So this, which one to be taken? This call is normally taken by your accounts people. They will say, okay, maintain it as 100% discount or maintain it as zero price. Okay. So, they will take this call, but you have to know where this setting has to be done. They will tell you, I don't want the price for free goods. Okay. So, you maintain it accordingly. They just say that. Okay. So, you have to come and change in your item category. So, my free goods item category is TANN. Okay. For that, so, as of now, the standard setting, it is give the full price and the 100% discount. Okay. So that is what. So if I go to determine item category for free goods item, it is going to take me to the item category determination in the sales order. Okay. So what is my sales order? OR. Okay. Item category group is norm. Okay. Item usage is, I don't have anything. My top level item is TAN. Okay. For this combination, the system determines TANN. So, in the item category configuration, I go and say for TANN, give either full price and 100% discount or no pricing at all. Okay. So, we had done that. So, now, let me come to the free condition records creation for free goods. So, that is in the EC access screen, logistics, sales and distribution, master data, conditions, free goods. I come to the free goods determination. I click the key combination. Now I could see the condition tables which I had entered. Okay. So, before going into the price list, let me see what any of my customers to which price list he or she belongs to. So, /N VD02. Price list is found in the sales area tab. So that is why I am going to the transaction code VD02, okay, T-S62A01 is my customer, 1000-10-00. I go to sales data. Here I can see the price list. Okay, this customer belongs to 03. Okay, so now what I am going to do, instead of creating for the single customer, I am going to create for a particular price group, that is whomever belongs to industry customers. So you will see what are the values for that: wholesale, retail, industry, public sector. Okay, so I am saying whomever belongs to the industry sector, I want to create a free goods for them. So I am selecting the price list. So my price list is 03. Okay. So like I told you, while creating the condition table, I am selecting with validity, with period of validity. So that is the effect here. It says valid from to which date. So let me say I am going to create it for only today. So for all the sales orders I make today, I will be getting these free goods. Okay. So okay. We talked about inclusive and exclusive. So by default, the system takes you to the inclusive free goods screen. Okay. If you want to maintain exclusive, even before you enter anything in the first line, you have to click this inclusive or exclusive button. Okay. So let me maintain the first one for inclusive. So I am entering the article T-AAT101. Okay. There is something called as minimum quantity. For example, even though you say buy one get one free, the customer must have bought a minimum quantity to get that free good. For example, even though you say like buy one get one free, it is not like the customer is going to get that one free quantity right from the first quantity. If you set it as 12, only when they buy 12 pieces, they will be getting the free goods benefit. Even if they buy 11, they won't get any free goods. They will get only 11. The moment the purchasing quantity touches 12, okay, the free goods is activated for another one free. So they will get another 12 free. So that is the minimum quantity. So let me say, okay, as of now, let me leave the minimum quantity as 1. Okay. From 10 pieces, two are free goods. Okay. Which means if the customer buys 10 pieces, in that 10, 2 will be free. It's not that for 10 they will be adding 2. This is inclusive. So if the customer buys 10 pieces, out of that, 2 will be free. Okay. So then we come to the calculation rule. Okay. The calculation rule is automatically taken by the system. One is the prorata basis. Prorata basis, I believe you are aware of what a prorata means. Okay. So for in this case, okay, I created two free for 10, which means I can, if I bring it to the lowest denominator, it comes to like 1 for 5. Okay. So tomorrow if this customer is buying 25 pieces, okay, so he will be getting 5 free, because for 10, 2. Another 10, 2. For remaining 5, 1. So out of 25, the customer will be getting 5 free goods, whereas 10 is the, 20 is the main item or priceable item. This is calculated by prorata basis. Okay. The next one is the unit reference. Unit reference means the system will take the calculate the free goods only for the whole units in the sense, like for example, we had told for 10 pieces 2 is free. Okay, tomorrow the customer buys 25 pieces, for 10 pieces 2 pieces free, so for 20 pieces he will get 4 pieces free, which means out of 25 only 4 is free. He will be charged for 21, because for that remaining 5 quantity the system didn't calculate any free goods, because it is not a round unit or something. Okay. So third one is the unit, whole unit. Whole unit, I really don't know why this whole unit is given, in which circumstance it's being used, but it goes like for 10, 2. If anything is more than 10 or less than 10, the system will ignore that condition completely. For example, if the customer is ordering 100 pieces, the system will check 100 is not equal to the whole unit 10. So there is no free good. So even if the customer buys 100 pieces, he won't be getting any free good. Okay. So if you want to activate the whole unit concept, then for this 100 pieces scenario, you have to enter 10 lines of 10 pieces each so that the system can calculate the free goods. Okay. So by default, the system takes the prorata concept. Okay. Then finally, it says whether the free goods has to be done inclusive, which means, for example, you just now you had said when we buy 10 pieces, out of that 10, 2 must be free, which means the customer is buying 10 and you will be invoicing only 8. If you want to show that free item as a separate line, then choose the option 1. Okay. But you don't want to show that free goods explicitly. Instead, you want it to be treated discretely, which means the value will be showing as only 10 pieces. Okay. But you will be charged for only 8 pieces. If that is the case, choose the option 2. Okay, so we will see the both. Okay. So first line I am choosing the, I want the system to generate a separate line for free goods. Okay. Similarly, I am creating another one, T-AT102. Okay. Minimum quantity 1, the same one for 10 pieces. I am adding 2 pieces free, is going to be my prorata basis, but I don't want the system to generate a separate line for free goods. So it must be discrete one. Okay. So I have chosen the 3. Here, like pricing, here also we can use the concept of scales, which means, okay, up to 10 pieces, I can enable the 2 pieces for 10, this thing. So, if somebody crosses 50, I want to increase the free quantity from 2 to, let me say, 3 or 5. To do that, select the particular line and click the blue color scales button. So, here, what is the minimum quantity? Okay, I am saying from 51 pieces, sorry, from 51 pieces, okay, for 10 pieces, I want 4 pieces as free goods. Okay, which means up to 50 pieces when the customer buys, he will be getting 2 pieces free for 10 pieces. Which means up to 50 he will be getting, okay, if he buys 50, he will be getting 40 main items and 10 free items. Okay. But if you buy 60, okay, it will be 4, which means how much? So 6 into 4 is 24. 24 is free goods and 36 is the free goods, I mean main item. Okay, so this is the scale. I have created it for only 1 day validity. Okay, so tomorrow when you people practice, you create for some other days. Okay, so I'm going to save it. So slash and VA01. So let me check for another customer who belongs to the same. Okay, A01. I believe A02 must also have the same one. Okay, yeah, A02 also belongs to industry. Same condition. So, I'm also creating sales order. Okay. For I believe it's going to get disconnected. So let us see. Downloading. Okay. So T-62. Three goods. Yeah. 2780101. Mine is 10 pieces. Okay, that is the condition records I had maintained. So enter 10 pieces. Can you see the system generates here separate line for three goods? Even though you had entered only 10, the system splits that into 8 plus 2 because 2 is the three goods, and it has created here, I mean, it is generating with a new item category TANN. Okay, so let us go to the another one T-8102. That is also we created for 10 pieces condition records. Okay, so but TA102 didn't create any separate lines. Okay, even though we had maintained the three goods, it didn't create any separate lines. So let us go and check in the conditions. Okay. Can you see there is a condition type NRAB? So NRAB is active with 520.16 euros, which means for 520, I mean, what is the value of price per, okay, 100, I'll do one thing, so let me delete all these discounts. Okay, so my price is 400, okay. So my total value for 10 pieces is 4000. Okay. Out of 10, 2 is free. Okay. So the system has activated the condition type NRAB for 2 pieces, which means out of 4000, 800 is reduced for the remaining 2 pieces, even though it is not shown explicitly. Okay. So your condition value becomes 3200. Understood? Did you understand the difference between the, I mean, like item line generation and without item line generation? Okay. For our previous quantity, I mean, for previous line, 8101, in the condition records, I maintained that the system must create a separate line for free goods. Okay. Slash NVBN2. Okay. I'm just changing for my TDL. No. See, in this line for free goods, I had maintained the system must generate a new line for free goods, inclusive rebate with item generation. So that is why the system created a separate line for your free goods. Okay. Whereas for 102, I created with a free goods type 03, that is without item generation, item line generation, that is only for sales. Okay. So without item line generation, the system has activated the free goods. So that is why for 102, even though I don't have the free goods shown explicitly, it has been done through the pricing. So in the pricing, I could see 2 pieces, that is 800 euros has been reduced or deducted for the free goods. Okay, I bought 10, so my overall value was 4000, out of which 2 is free, so the system reduced the 800, even though it didn't create any separate lines for free goods. So this is the inclusive rebate with and without item generation. So let me create another free goods condition record slash NVBN1. So let me say, this time let me create it for a particular customer. So this is my customer. My date is 90908-2011. Okay, before that I must have clicked the inclusive or exclusive. If I try to, it will give an error. So I am coming out of this. Key combination, customer material. Before entering, I am just clicking the exclusive. Okay, now the system moves to exclusive view and it says free goods view exclusive. For item P-AT-103, minimum quantity 1, for 10 pieces, add 2 pieces of free goods. My free material is T-AT-101. Okay. So this is my thing. So calculation rule 1, it says it is the pro rata basis. Okay. And this free goods rule 2 says that it is the exclusive one. Okay. It is neither inclusive with item nor inclusive without item generation. Instead, it is an exclusive one. Okay. Here also, I can maintain the scale value. Okay. So, let me say maintain a scale of from 51 for 10 pieces, add 5 pieces free of this article T-AT-101. If you want to maintain different material also, you can do that. This means if the customer crosses the 50 pieces, then I want to, instead of 101, I want to give 102. That is also possible. Okay. So, I come back. So, let me say this. Okay. Slash NVA01 or exclusive free goods. Okay, T-AT-103, 10 pieces. See, the system has created another line of 101, 2 pieces. Okay. Similarly, I can maintain for, I mean, like when I said exclusively, okay, I took the safe route by defining the additional material as the different material from the main item. Okay, now I can say I can maintain the exclusive goods for the same item. For example, okay, for this combination, let me go only for material entered. So before that, exclusive. Okay, T-AT-104, okay, minimum quantity is 1, for 10 pieces of free gift, add 2 pieces of free goods, okay, that also I am entering the same article, T-AT-104. Can you see, now this is a exclusive one, I mean exclusive free goods. But main item and sub item or main item and free item are the same articles. So that is why don't buy the theory that if the main item and free goods item are the same, then it is a inclusive. No, not necessary. Okay. So I am creating a sales order slash an EA01. Free goods. Okay. Inclusive and exclusive. T hyphen AT104. So my order quantity is 10 pieces. Okay. The free goods are also determined as the, with the exclusive one, and it determines the free goods with the same item. Okay. So let me go back to my 101. This is the inclusive one. Can you see, even though that inclusive is also creating a separate line, it was not within that 10. I mean, it is not above the 10. Instead, the free goods was within that 10. Okay. But in this case, exclusive means it is above the invoiced purchased quantity or ordered quantity. Okay. So, I ordered 10. For that 10, I am getting 2 extra free. But in case of 101, I ordered 10, within that 10, 2 is free. So that is the inclusive and exclusive difference. Okay, is it clear? Okay. So with that, we come to the end of free goods determination. So, I mean, like, you people can create your own condition tables, your own combinations of, okay. Else you can replicate the same existing tables, create your own access sequence. I think Sirisha can better do because she has a separate document type and that thing. Okay. So she can active document type sales organization everything. So I expect Sirisha to create a new pricing, free goods determination procedure and show it in the tomorrow's class. Okay. Because others hadn't, I mean, Abhid and Preeti, they hadn't created their document types and other things. Okay. So you had the document type. Great, Preeti. Then I expect you also to do that. Yeah, sure. I'll do that, yeah. Okay. So, this is the free goods. And we'll see the material determination tomorrow. So, once tomorrow's exercise is over, then I can send you that complete thing. Okay, which you can do it for this weekend. So, you have to create right from your document type creation. So, you will be having various scenarios in that. Okay. So, they will be like giving like story format. So, they